And the question is, when I make my own kit, how do I save it so I don't have to manually create it again in another project? So this is very simple in a way, but yeah, so you can also do this with every plugin basically. But let's go to FL Studio here, and let's open up this one, and let's open DirectWave. It's sampler, DirectWave. So let's say that you are creating your own kit. So let's load a couple of sounds here. Let's go here, drums, and let's do kick. Let's bring a kick here, and let's make the kick just one note. So this would be the kick. Let's open up a hi-hat. Let's do the same thing here. And let's add just a snare, so just you, so that you can have an understanding of what's happening here. So if I now play, I'm clicking on my keyboard, and you see that this is triggering some of the sounds that I added here. So let's say that I created this kit. Now I want to save this. So because then if you don't save this or this configuration here, what happens is that every time you open up a new project, you have to create the kits. And that sucks, to be honest. That's not, you don't want that, because if you have to create a kit every time you open up your project, then it takes the fun out of making music, and it's not really, really exciting. So to save the project, you can come here and you just do save preset as. That simple. And you can do basic, let's call this basic kit. Okay, save it. Let's create a new project, new. Let's remove that. Let's do sampler direct wave. And now if I go here to my presets, you can see that I have the basic kick. So I just load it, and now I still have the sounds that I just loaded to direct wave. And of course you can do this with every single plugin. For instance, I can show you, that's not what I meant. I can show you, for instance, the FPC, and I've done a bunch of presets for this one. As you can see, I have my own headbanging trap drums. I have here 16 kicks, crashes, hi-hats, kicks, two kits and snares. I have a bunch of ones from samples from Mars, from old drum machines. I have here my soprano drums, and I have also some techno kits. So I, to be honest, I don't know where these kits are located anymore. And I just, whenever I need some of these presets, I just, if I need some techno kicks, I come here and very simply I have some kicks to play around with. And this is very, very good. And it really saves you a lot of time setting up projects or working with projects. If you have all your kits created, you can just load whatever plugin you want, just load the kit that you want, and you are good to go. And you don't have to think about or worry about where are your sounds located. You just have access to them directly here in the preset selector. And I think that's it for this question. So thanks for asking the question. Unfortunately, I do not know who posted the question right now, but what I'm going to do later is to link this video to that question so that you know where is the answer for this question.